partnered by Times Influence.
Hello and welcome to yet another inspiring episode of India's Finest Workplaces. Today we bring you a company that is helping India fight against the epidemic of diabetes and other chronic diseases.
Novo Nordisk is a joint venture between two Danish companies, Nordisk Insulin Laboratorium and Novo Therapeutisk Laboratorium, founded in 1923 and 1925 respectively. Today, it is a global healthcare company with path-breaking innovation in diabetes care. This heritage gives Novo Nordisk the experience and capabilities that enables them to help people defeat other serious chronic conditions such as haemophilia and other growth disorders.
Novo Nordisk have more than 42,000 employees around the world. The way we operate our business is via the triple bottom line principle. What it basically means is that we will guide our decisions, we will guide our business by taking care of economic bottom line, a social bottom line, and an environmental bottom line. As it concerns the economic bottom line, that's the straightforward financial measurements. When it concerns social bottom line, we want to make sure that we as a company treat our employees right, but we also want to make sure that the environment, the society in which we operate, we also pay our respect and help those societies develop. And last but not least, the environmental bottom line is to make sure that the way we operate, the way we produce our products is environmentally sustainable.
In 1923, two Danish founders began a journey to fight against the menace of diabetes. Today, Novo Nordisk has over thousands of employees. So let's find out how Novo Nordisk is taking care of its employees. The genesis of Novo Nordisk India goes back to the 90s, and today it is the fifth largest and one of the fastest growing pharma MNCs in India. The company has grown from a 26 member team to a 1200 employee base today. And to find out more about this spectacular journey, we have got in touch with their managing director, Melvin D'Souza. Melvin, welcome to India's Finest Workplaces.
Thank you very much.
To begin with, can you talk to us about the various changes that you have witnessed in your organization and how has your workforce helped you achieve it?
I think so, several changes over the last 12 years. I think so, first and foremost, the company's business grew by 5 times. I think so, that is fantastic. And that also shows the power behind that performance, and that is people. Mm-hmm. As an organization, we grew by at least 3 times. That also showed the type of, you know, the business that we are in. That means the patients, the service that we have to provide in the market. And I think so we have been really very fortunate that we could provide that leadership in the market and make people out there feel our presence. And it is quite visible in the type of work our people do. And I'm really proud of the people who've been working behind this. I think so we have a fantastic team who delivers it day in and day out.
You just said that you have a fantastic team. So Melvin, can you talk to us about your most memorable employee experience?
I think so, quite a few, because I like to be in the field all the time. When you are in the field, you really see the action that we are in. You really like to see the end user who actually, you know, he is benefiting from the products that we use. Mm-hmm. I can bring back some memories where I can see people working very, very late in the night to possibly meet a customer. Mm-hmm. And also see employees, in spite of their personal challenges, who actually would have delivered exceptional service. I'm really proud of a person who actually has an end stage disease, and in spite of that, is one of our best employees out there in the field. I think so, that is quite inspiring, and I cannot you know, distinguished him or her from any other people who are in the company.
All right. So you are in the healthcare sector and you are changing lives of, you know, people who are affected by diabetes or suffering from diabetes. What are the various healthcare benefits you offer to your employees? Take us through some of them.
I think so. At Novo Nordisk, I can say we always talk about work hard and play hard. And to possibly deliver both of this, mm-hmm. you actually require healthy people. One of the things is we have a comprehensive, possibly the best, insurance program for people to cover, and also health benefits which actually reach out to them every year. We not only encourage our employees to participate very heavily in sport, because we believe being in sport, some sort of sport or some sort of exercise, is extremely important to deliver exceptional performance. To our credit, we have two big teams. We have a cycling team, which is also an offshoot of the team that we have in a global level, where we have type 1 people. But in our offices, we have a cycling team which is run by various people, run through our management groups. We also have a running team, which actually is running, trying to add up the miles which everybody runs through and possibly, you know, bring in awareness. And I think so that also brings in the overall face of the organization to try and build that ability to be showing as, yes, we are fun loving. We are also very keen about people's health and trying to make them lead a really normal life.
So on this note, Melvin, let's take a look at what your employees have to say about the healthcare programs offered to them at Novo Nordisk. Take a look.
Are given a platform by the organization, by the management team, that we can actually go and participate and take up challenges which are higher and which I don't think any other companies are currently offering. Like, I did participate in two international marathons and also one international cycle ride. It was basically a JDRF ride to cure in Colorado, US. So it was a very challenging task for me. And me being a fitness freak at heart, it actually connects me to Novo Nordisk.
A Novo Health program also avails benefit for all the employees to undergo employee annual health checkup. And this is a great benefit, I can tell you. And this is also offered to all the family members as well in a discounted price.
Diabetes is spreading in India like an epidemic. And how are you, you know, striving to change this scenario?
Yes, I think changing diabetes is core to whatever we do. Being a leader in diabetes care, it also is extremely important for an organization like us to have programs which can actually mean a lot, not only by selling a medication, but also making sure that we are able to address the issue of diabetes care, the burden of diabetes care. India is one of the, you know, countries which possibly houses the maximum number of diabetics. Mm-hmm. And if in some way we are able to attempt to try and bend that curve of that unrelenting epidemic, I think so it goes a long way in building a society which is very healthy.
On this note, Melvin, we would like to show our audiences what changing diabetes is all about and also hear from your employees on this initiative. Take a look.
My association with Novo Nordisk is actually 28 years old. Not that I was working at that time, but I was a child, 11 years old child, diagnosed with type 1 diabetes. It was a tough time at that time because I was getting weak, and that insulin and the care of my parents and doctors get me back to life. And since then, there is an association with Novo Nordisk by me. Now, I remember in year 1995, Novo Nordisk introduced a magazine called Prerna. Prerna was a magazine for people with diabetes, or patient initiative, and I used to wait for it because it was such a lovely thing which not only gave insights about living with diabetes but also gave hope, inspiration that people with diabetes can live long, healthy lives. And now I'm one of the editors of Prerna magazine. That was my journey and motivation to become a diabetes educator. Diabetes needs to be managed 24/7. It goes with the child everywhere the child goes. Now I'd like to show some of the initiatives and material which through this program we had developed and are benefiting the children. Diet is an important part of management of diabetes, and for children it becomes very difficult. For this, we had made Make Your Own Plate. Make Your Own Plate give the child ample options to eat. This is Naughty Doll. This helps the child to be the child, but yet understand how to take insulin, where to take insulin, rotation of insulin sites in a friendly manner.
How do your employees and yourself, you know, take out time and balance business and personal life?
I think so. It's a very good question, because the fun part of every time that we talk about is there is work and there is life. But I think so. We'll need to make a meaning between the two. I think so. When it comes to work, I think building in professional skills becomes extremely important, especially if you're working in a healthcare space. We were probably the first companies to actually work with technology in the sales organization. Mm-hmm. Way back in 2007, we are the first companies to actually build out detailing through iPads, and also digitally recording many of the attempts when you look at working and tracking work, trying to analyze the work that we do. So that is one part of the professional work that we do, trying to make things easier, much more visible, much more agile. The second part is the life. Mm-hmm. And I think as an organization, we have been very much interested in working around pieces of diversity, especially around women. We also work around health per se. Because like I said, if you're working with a chronic disorder like diabetes, it's also very important that we address issues which are related to people.
It's time for a short break, but on the other side, we will bring you more on what makes Novo Nordisk one of the finest workplaces in India.
Welcome back to India's Finest Workplaces. Being a patient-centric company and delivering competitive financial results is challenging, especially in India, where government policies and business environment is ever-changing. But Novo Nordisk has not only managed to help patients live better lives, but has also offered attractive rewards to its employees.
Also, talk to us about the various employee benefit programs that you offer to your employees. Some of the best practices.
I think so. One of the best practices that we are able to give our employees, or rather say talk about it a lot, is that the leave programs that we have. We were probably the first companies to actually extend the maternity leave program for women. Mm-hmm. Much before even the government would have talked about it. The government started it probably a year back. We were probably up in that space probably a couple of years before that.
That's wonderful.
Another good thing that we also do is what we also have is some many a times people are off jobs for whatever reason. It might be a sabbatical, it might be a pregnancy leave.
Right.
But we would like to also secure their return back into those places. Mm-hmm. So we also have a sort of a person who can, double up for them during that period.
Okay.
And we also make sure that we can secure their place when they are back.
On that note, Melvin, we would like to bring you some more reactions from your employees on their favorite initiatives. Take a look.
Way before, Government of India brought this policy of taking 26 weeks of maternity leave, but before that, Novo Nordisk brought it into existence.
We have a friendly environment and culture provided in Novo Nordisk, and we feel more secure, comfortable working with Novo Nordisk. Like, we are completely taken care of by Novo Nordisk. And in fact, like in a monthly meetings, wherever we go, the overnight accommodation stay and all will be taken care of the company.
Moving on, Melvin, money is a motivating factor when it comes to employee performance. So can you talk to us about your increment programs and also the other monetary gains offered to your employees?
I think so. The proof in the pudding lies in talking to people actually who are the beneficiaries of this.
Okay.
Many a times we try to make the best of what the environment allows us to do. Like I said, we are also financially responsible organization. Two, it's very important that we try and balance the type of compensation that we offer in the market. So we have a compensation plan which possibly is at what the market provides. One, I wouldn't say, you know, it's way out of the world, but I can say it's probably one of the best that we can offer. I think money is an integral and a very important part of the compensation package. But all what comes along with that, the experience, the ability to give back to the society, the ability to do independent work, which you can really be proud about and carry forward in your life, is another part which we believe is also an integral part of your compensation.
Absolutely.
That is why we say our compensation packages or our people and organization strategy also revolves around providing life-changing careers.
So Melvin, on this note, we would like to bring in some reactions from your employees about their career growth and their work-life balance. Here's what they said.
Okay, when we know Nordisk, we have a phrase called life-changing careers. Okay, one example is standing in front of you. My journey started 18 years back. I call myself born and brought up in Novo Nordisk because I started my career with Novo Nordisk. And it was in a sales rep role, and I think that 1 year stays with me forever because that brought me very close to what the customer need in the market. And since then, my passion was in marketing. So I had various opportunities to learn and grow in the organization.
When I started, I joined Novo Nordisk as a medical advisor for the growth hormone, and the organization decided to build the organization to conduct clinical trial. And as I mentioned, we started with two employees in my team, and then I started focusing on the clinical operation.
This can be seen as an unusual career option for a woman, but company like Novo Nordisk provides us the environment like that where we can work out, not less than a man.
It's been fantastic, as in the journey has been, it has been a journey of learning. It has been a journey wherein, you know, we understand how various patients go through in this particular problem and what is the value that Novo Nordisk can bring to them.
This is my 34th year in the industry and the 14th year in Novo Nordisk. And I'm really proud to be part of this organization, which is so much focused to improving lives of people.
Well, I always wanted to work for a company which is high in reputation, ethical, and working towards the general society as such. And Novo Nordisk is the market leader in diabetes.
My last question to you is, take us through some of the employee engagement programs that you offer to your employees.
I think so, several engagement programs in this organization. I think those starting with, we have the Grand National Sales Meeting, okay, where possibly 10 years back, we took this opportunity to call all people on one stage,
okay,
and start celebrating performances and also talking about what we would like to do for the whole year. So I can tell you it is a great occasion for people to engage themselves in various activities and actions. So also to add to it, we have regular interactions, our offsites, the action-oriented meetings that we have at various points in time, which builds in tremendous engagement within people. We also have great engagement programs for people to actually try and build up their skills.
Mm-hmm.
Many of it which we will see and talk as we go through the organization.
And when it comes to food for thought, Novo Nordisk takes this analogy quite literally. The company offers healthy and subsidized food options to its employees that help them look forward to their snack breaks.
So Melvin, we are at the back office department of your campus in Bangalore. We'll continue with our conversation. Can you talk to us about the infrastructure, the office infrastructure in general?
Yes, I think Novo Nordisk grew very fast over the last 20-25 years.
Mm-hmm.
If you go back, way back in 1994, we started with this very, very small office which could hardly accommodate 5 people on MG Road, and that was in Bangalore. And from then on, I think so, the journey has been phenomenal, and we have shifted places 6 times in that period. The only longest stint we had was in the Whitefield area. And this is the office that we actually sort of came into in 2007.
Mm-hmm.
And I think from then on, we have added a lot of people, and that is also signifies the growth
that the company has gone through.
So Melvin, I would like to bring in the rewards and recognition question once again, but this time for the staff functions. So can you talk to us more about that?
The second part of our rewards and recognition, especially around recognition, is to recognize the history of working in this organization. Mm-hmm. Like I started saying, when you're working in a chronic area, you require people also to work for a long period of time in an organization. And we also recognize people who spend a lot of time in the organization, be it for 5 years, be it for 10 years, 15 years, and 20 years, and 25 years. So we have this rich tradition of having a gold coin, which is passed on to people once they finish 10 years, and so on and so forth. So it is quite an interesting thing to look at and also cherish part of their memory, but at the same time also probably signifying the value that they create for the organization. To recognize and to actually sort of celebrate good performances in your staff functions who actually are supporting the day, the hard work which has been done by people in the front is also quite important. Mm-hmm. To that effect, we have started programs, what we call as the People Choice Award, where we recognize excellent performances but done by people in staff functions in the back office who actually have contributed to exceptional work on a quarterly basis.
So Melvin, on this note, we got in touch with some of your employees. Let's have a look at what they have to say about the rewards and recognition programs offered to them. Take a look.
I would like to tell you that when I completed 15 years in Novo Nordisk, I got a gold coin of 15 grams. And now I look forward to receiving 20 grams gold coin when I complete 20 years in coming June.
Novo Nordisk, if you achieve your sales budget, you'll be rewarded with the cash, and also there will be certificates and yearly rewards. We'll be having a national sales meet where your achievements will be like recognized, and in front of everyone you'll be given certificates and all. And also there will be CDP points kind of thing where you can climb up the ladder and you can achieve your goals.
Can you talk to us about the training and development programs offered to employees?
Training and development are an integral part of a growing organization. At Novo Nordisk, we have a very serious effort in doing that, especially when I come and look at training. I think so training becomes part of the work in every functional area that we have. Since we are in a knowledge field, updating ourselves, regularly making sure that our people are at the cutting edge of looking at technology and the work that has been growing in that space, we have continuously worked on training programs, not only for the sales organization, for people from various departments who have to log in the training time which they get into that space. Mm-hmm. The second piece is the development piece, where we also see when you have a growing organization, we also have people progressing in their careers. So we start off with the simple rule of 20-80. Mm-hmm. In the sense, we have at least 20% of our organization involved in some sort of development program right from the beginning.
Melvin, we also got in touch with some of your employees who have gained from the various training and development programs offered to them. Here's what they said.
The company focus is always on employee focus, and mainly on the training and development. Mm-hmm. Because we not only on the on-job training, the company has also at every intervals of my career progression, the company has given me an opportunity to attend courses in Indian Institute of Management and executive development programs.
This training was basically a talent development program. This was a long duration program, and it's a flagship program when it comes to leadership development. So I had the opportunity to be part of this program. Yes, in terms of the highlights of the program, yes, it was focusing a lot on management concepts, and being a participant amongst, you know, employees from other affiliates was one of the best experience that I've had.
I joined Novo Nordisk in 2008 as a hospital executive, and now I'm working as a regional manager, and I have a team size of almost 60 people reporting to me. And Novo Nordisk has always provided growth opportunities to high performing individuals through in-house as well as external training programs.
Because we all need to chill out and take a breather from the hectic day at work, Novo Nordisk offers various options to its employees to unwind. from a wellness room to take a nap or finishing a board of carom with your colleagues or just sipping coffee with your work pal, employees are very well taken care of.
With an approach that is both patient and employee-centric when it comes to their work culture, Novo Nordisk is one of the sought-after companies to work for. That's all we have on this episode of India's Finest Workplaces. Many thanks for watching.
Partnered by Times Influence.